Hi guys, this is Andrew Nup, and these are the best games of the week. First up, we have Mother of Myth, published by Planary. This is a really amazing RPG. The graphics and animations look really nice, and the game has really high production value. So you tap to move in this game, and you tap enemies to attack them. This game has cool skills with gesture controls, so you draw out certain shapes to do certain skills. It works out pretty well. There's a lot of chapters and levels to go through, and the game has a fully voice acted story, and the story is pretty good. This is definitely one of the best free RPGs out there, so go check it out. Next up, we have Edge of Tomorrow Game, published by Warner Bros. Here's an interesting first-person shooter based on the movie. The graphics are actually quite good, and there's tons of effects and stuff going on all over the place. There's all these explosions, and you also have teammates nearby moving around with you. So in this game, you keep moving forward to your destination. While trying not to die, there's these aliens that move incredibly weird. They're super fast and insanely crazy. So you move with a joystick and you aim your crosshair at enemies to automatically shoot. It's actually a pretty cool game. Next up, we have Tiny Dice Dungeon, published by Kongregate. This is a dice-based RPG. The graphics are 8-bit, but they still look pretty good. So the combat is turn-based. You go through levels and fight enemies by rolling a dice. So when you start out, your character has 2 dice, and the numbers you roll on the dice is how much damage you do. You can actually roll the dice as many times you want in one turn. But if you roll a 1, you miss and you lose your turn. So although you can roll as many times you want, you do have to play it safe, but it is an interesting RPG. There's lots of monsters, lots of levels, worth checking out. Next up, we have Legend of Roland, published by Happy Mage. This is the same game as Fantasy Heroes, but with a new publisher. It's a really fun RPG. So you control a group of characters, and there's more characters to unlock along the way. You can drag your characters to move around, or tap to move and attack. There's skills to use, and the graphics are quite good. This game actually has a good story, and there's tons of character dialogue. There's lots of levels to go through, different monsters to fight. This is a fun RPG of lots of content. Next up, we have Doom Tower, published by Yagoda Production. Here's a cool casual game. You play a guy sitting there, and enemies appear trying to kill him. So the goal is to protect your guy by swiping or tapping enemies to kill them. After each wave, the camera angle suddenly changes. It is fun with the gesture controls, and the graphics are not bad. It's a fun casual game with lots of action. Next up, we have Striker Soccer 2, published by Chillingo. So here's a soccer/football game, whatever you want to call it. It's like a cartoony version of FIFA. So there's tons of teams to choose from, many of which are real teams, but all the players have like fake names. So you can control your character with a joystick, and you can pass and shoot when you're on offense, and steal and slide on defense. It's actually not too bad, the controls are decent. It's not as good as FIFA, but it's still a good football game. Next up, we have Extreme Dirt, published by Makemake Games. Here's a cool trials bike game. The graphics aren't too bad, and the game actually has pretty good physics. So you can hold a button to accelerate and can lean forward or lean back. You can also jump, so you go through obstacle courses, and it's actually really fun doing backflips, front flips, and going through the obstacles without crashing. Until Trials Frontier comes out, this is a really fun trials bike game to check out. Next up, we have Godzilla Smash 3, published by Rogueplay. Here's a Godzilla-themed puzzle game. So you play Godzilla and you match the gems to attack enemies. It's a fairly standard match 3 game. The animations are nice and there's lots of levels to go through. You can shoot lasers out of your mouth, and it's an interesting game to check out. I'm a fire in my laser! Next is School Idol Festival, published by K-Lab. Here's an interesting music-based game. So in this game, you can create a music group, and there is a story, there's lots of dialogue. So the actual gameplay is when you perform live shows. So it shows your performers here, and circles come down toward the performers, and you have to tap the character at the right time when the circle goes over them. So it's like one of those music-based games. After each live show, you can unlock new characters to join you. It's an interesting music-based casual game. And last, we have Tiny Runner's Multiplayer Race, published by Almond Play. Here's a cute little endless running racing game. So in this game, you race against 3 other people online. So you can swipe left and right to move left and right, and you can swipe up to jump. There's also power-ups to use. So it's kind of like a kart racer fused with an endless runner. The gameplay isn't super smooth, but it's a fun game to play. The only con is that there's very little people in the game. Anyway, that's all for this week. Make sure you guys subscribe for more videos, and thanks for watching.
Executed.